And good day to all of you. So my name is Michael C. Pasis from Makua University, Morelia and Camarones, Manila, Philippines. And welcome to my online electrical engineering review tutorial channel. So to those who are new, you can subscribe at the right side of your of the page of YouTube, and you can subscribe on my channel for additional information, for update lectures, and other stuffs for my channel. So today, we will discuss the effect of temperature in the resistance of the conductor. From our last lesson, we discussed fundamental resistance. Today, we will discuss if the resistance have a variation on temperature, what will be the new resistance, okay, using fundamentals and concepts. So here, we will first tackle some definitions, especially here, the T constant. So I call it a T constant. So the T here is the inferred absolute zero resistance temperature. So it means if you have a conductor, okay, and it is placed on various temperature, if it's cold or hot, okay, there's a certain temperature that the resistance will become zero. And these values here are based on experimental values. So, since we have two typical conductors that we have already discussed, so we will stick to it. Although there are some constants for every conductors like steel and carbon and iron conductors. So, in this case, we will discuss the typical conductors that is being used in a transmission line. Okay, we have here the temperature constant or the inferred absolute zero resistance for copper and also for aluminum. Okay, now we have here a negative 234.5 for copper. And we have a negative, 228.1 degrees centigrade for aluminum. It means that at negative 234.5, the resistance will become zero if you cool the conductor, the copper conductor. So we have two values here, the black ones and the blue ones. The black ones means the copper is annealed or preheated first. And the blue ones here are the hard-drawn values. So, hard-drawn values. So, whatever the values that you can substitute on the formulas, which we will discuss in the latter part of the discussion, is still the same. The only difference is a little bit of significant figures. But, again, there's there's a little bit of change on the values, but we usually use typical values as 234.5 and 228.1 for aluminum and copper respectively. Okay, what's the meaning of the negative value? So I have here a graph, okay, that constitutes to the variation of the resistance and temperature, that if you have a copper conductor in this example, it will be cooled down to negative 234.5, wherein the resistance is zero. And the value is negative 234.5. So it's clear as well that if we heat the conductor, it will also rise the temperature and the resistance. So we have here a straightforward or a linear relationship. So you have here three significant points. So this first point here is R0 and T0. And then you have some slopes here. You have R1 and T1, no, for this another point. And another point here for our two people. And then one important formula as well is this, no, the temperature coefficient of resistance at 0 degrees centigrade for alpha 0. And it is designated by alpha 0 is equal to 1 all over T. So please take note that I have here the formulas in a box form so that you can jot down on your notes and so that you can always remember or recall them, because these are very, very important. And we can use the theory of similar triangles in getting the relationship of R0, T0 from the first point, also R1 and T1, and R2 and T2 by using similar triangles. So we will make use of this relationship on our next slide. So please stand by. For the continuation of what we have discussed from the first slide or the previous slide, so we make use of that graph, okay, for the derivation of the resistances versus temperature on various conditions. It can be R2 with respect to R0, or R2 with respect to R1, R1 with respect to R0, etc. Okay, we make use first of the 234.5 value here from the copper conductor, but we'll make use of that as an absolute value. So what's the main reason of this? What's the reason for this? Is instead of having a negative 234.5, since we are considering the x-axis as constant here from the previous slide from the graph, we make use of distance. So instead of negative 234.5, we make an absolute value so that we can make up for the total distance. Okay, now, by using similar triangles, no, so we can have this R0 all over T0 plus 234.5 and R2 all over T2 plus 234.5. Okay, but however, the T0 here is 0 already. So let's move forward here at the left side. Okay, so we arrange the equation again. So that will become R2 over R0, T2 plus 234.5 all over 234.5, and T0 is already 0. And then we can simplify it further by having this term become like this. Okay, it becomes 1 plus T2 all over T2 times 1 all over T. So, rearranging the equation, then we can have this relationship that R2 is equal to R0 multiplied by 1 plus T2 all over T. Wherein, again, the T here, okay, is our inferred temperature zero resistance, or the T constant. Okay, similarly, if we use here the relationship of R1 with respect to R0, it will become like this, the same way. Rather, this one is T1. Okay, so please take note, okay, that we can further analyze this one in terms of a simple formula. So if we let alpha 0 from our previous discussion as 1 all over T, we can substitute this one on equations 1 and 2, and it will become like this, okay, which is dependent on the temperature coefficient. So thus, we can have R2 all over R1 is equal to 1 plus alpha 0 T2 all over 1 plus alpha 0 times T1. Okay, I can have this relationship, okay, that is depends on subscript. The T2 means also final temperature. T1 means initial temperature. So you can substitute also this one in terms of variables like RF all over RI or TF all over TI. Okay, but this is much better if we use the temperature constant. So if we divide 1 and 2 directly here, it will simplify as this equation, which is another important equation. And another coined term, lux fam, means lux fam means lux familiar formula. So here is a lux fam formula, which is R2 all over R1 simply equal to temperature T, or temperature constant temperature T, plus T2 all over T plus T1. And please take note, as I have mentioned from the previous slides, that the T here will be dependent on what type of conductor that you will use. Can that be copper, aluminum, steel, iron, etc. So for that, okay, you need to memorize that constant already. And this is a very, very, very useful formula, which we will apply on the problem solving. So we can derive some formulas on the next slide. So from the previous slide, we have already derived one important formula in terms of temperature constant T. Okay, now we will derive another important formula wherein the resistance will be in proportion to the temperature difference. So one way to derive that is we need to go back to the graph from our first slide, which is the R versus T graph. So I call this topic here as variations in terms of resistivity. So first, we need to have some basic assumptions. So if the area is constant and the length and length is constant, so it means that you use the same conductor material, but it only differs on the temperature. We could say from the R, dC is equal to rho L all over A, that the resistance will be proportional to the resistivity. Or we could say already here, if you have constant parameters of A and L, that R and resistivity will be the same. Okay, I coined this term as zoom 70%, no? So if you go back to the graph, I just concentrate on the R1 and R2 points there, okay? So you have here the temperature, the x-axis, and the y-axis here, R1 and R2. So our main goal here is to get these two points. So we can get the slope there by having the difference of R2 and R1 and T2 and T1. So if we arrange the equation, okay, in terms of resistivity, so as I have mentioned that resistivity can be also equal to your resistance. So get the resistivity 2 here, you can say that it is also resistivity. So get resistivity by arranging the equation, and then we have this equation here. Okay, so we can still simplify this one so that we can isolate resistivity 1. So we can have this formula here. However, on some of the experimental forms and theoretically, they can have this one, no, M all over rho 1 as the temperature coefficient of resistivity at temperature 1 or alpha 1. So we already know that alpha is temperature coefficient, but we have discussed from the previous slide that alpha there is alpha 0 at temperature 0. Here, alpha 1 or at dependent on temperature 1. So this can be simplified further as alpha 1. And hence, lux fam familiar or lux familiar or lux fam formula for us here, that resistivity 2 is equal to resistivity 1 plus alpha 1. Then temperature 2 minus temperature 1. Or in other words, the final formula can be, this is a very, very lux fam formula to all of us, that the final resistance, we can already have this in terms of resistance. Final resistance or RF is equal to RI You can have the subscript 2 into F, subscript 1 into I, 1 plus alpha I, or initial temperature coefficient, resistivity, Tf minus Di. Tf minus Di can be said to be delta T. Okay, let's go to the next slide. Okay, so this is another formula which is very, very important as well in determining the temperature coefficient at different temperature or variations in temperature. So we can recall our last formula that R final is equal to R initial 1 plus alpha initial delta T. So the delta T here is definitely Tf minus Ti. Okay, now we can have this in terms of the relationship in terms of the RT and T here. So we can have R2 is RT and T2 is equal to T. So if we correlate this one to this formula, we can have this first equation here that RT is equal to RO, 1 plus alpha 0, T minus 0. So the delta T here will be dependent if that is plus or minus. If the conductor is heated, meaning the final temperature is higher than the initial temperature, the delta T will become positive, which is very clear here, T minus 0 has a positive value. However, if the conductor is cooled, the temperature delta T will become negative because the final temperature is lower than the initial temperature. So if the conductor is cooled, it will become 0 minus T or a negative value. So we can have the first equation here as this one, RT is equal to R0, 1 plus alpha 0 times T. And then, if we have the conductor cooled, R0 is equal to RT, 1 plus alpha T, 0 minus T. So we have equation 1 and equation 2. Now, in the equation number 2, we can get alpha T here. No? The temperature coefficient at a certain temperature. So, if we arrange the equation, then we can have this equation number 3 here. Rather, this one, this whole equation here. Okay, if we substitute RT here, equation 1, to equation number 3, okay, and do the math and the algebra and simplification, this last equation is a very looks fun. Again, looks familiar formula. That's very, very important on getting the temperature coefficient at various temperature. And please take note that alpha 0 here is 1 all over T. Okay? And T here is the temperature at a certain value. Okay? And please take note that you can use this formula as long as the temperature constant or T is absolute value. Now, since we already discussed all of the theoreticals, we can now start solving problems on resistance versus temperature. See you.